Hello and welcome to New Sound Cafe here at worshiptogether.com. Today we're going to hear the song Endless Hallelujah by Matt Redman. Sit back and relax. We hope you enjoy this New Sound Cafe. Matt, it's good to see you again.
Good to see you too.
You're going to share the song An Endless Hallelujah?
Yes.
You're just sharing that it's a sort of a conglomeration of a bunch of different songwriters.
Yes, mostly alive.
Mostly alive and one mostly not.
Mostly dead.
Yeah.
There's an original hymn by a guy called Robert McShane, 1837. And it had some verse lyrics that we've
You get inspired
up
by,
a little bit.
And you sort of hack
and
them up.
And actually the phrase Endless Hallelujah is from another hymn altogether. So, you know, it's a little bit of something borrowed from here, something from here. And then Tomlin, we got in a room and we were working on the verses, chopping them up and all that. But the original tune melody and actually the lovely piano part, which you can hear on the recording, is a guy called Tim Wonstall from the UK.
Yeah.
And then Jonas Myron, the Swedish guy, he has to get in all these songs.
Yeah, somehow.
He helped on the chorus and the bridge.
Okay, great.
So it is actually a great teamwork thing because I just know there's no way the song would have ended up in the form it's in, and especially some of the musicality of it is something I couldn't have come up with. This lovely piano part which runs through it, which I won't be able to play you now.
Well, share the song with us, please.
When I stand before your throne, dressed in glory not my own, what a joy to sing of on that day. No more tears or broken dreams, forgotten is the mighty King. Everything as it was meant to be. And we will worship forever in your presence. We will sing, we will worship you. An endless hallelujah to the King. That's the verse and the chorus. The chorus has a lot of chords.
Yeah.
Obviously running through that, and they're not crazy difficult chords, but there's a lot of changes. It has a bit more of a hymny feel, I guess.
Yeah, absolutely.
So we've got worship, the C to the D, we've got the E minor to the G over B, worship, C forever, D. We will sing to the G, but there's some change in the second half, so we're going, and we will worship, C to the D again, but this time the other way around here. G over B to the E minor. Worship you. And instead of a C, an A minor. An endless hallelujah to the King. So a couple of changes there. Then we're into the bridge, which is probably the biggest part of the song. No more tears. No more shame. No more sin or sorrow ever known again. No more fears. No more pain. We're into a little piano motive here, but yeah, pretty simple chords. I actually played two shapes of B minor there, like the one I knew when I was 16 years old,
and
the one which is probably a better one, but
yeah.
I kind of like the different voicings on that, and yeah, and if you hear the recording, there's actually an instrumental as well, and that's just, it's probably a bit long to play now, but it's starts on the E minor, goes to the C, G and D, all that again, then it's actually building on the A minor to the C. And we really build up huge and then explode in some big choruses. And the song, I think, is like 7 minutes when we recorded it. You might want to find a shorter way.
A shorter version for your congregation. Well, it seems like that it is. It's a very easily playable song, but it sort of kind of leaves an open landscape for it to kind of be short and sweet or to be kind of a longer moment,
hopefully.
And I think that's the great thing about the song, especially that chorus, and you know, it's you know, that's a mark of great songs, is that they're not necessarily, you know, saying anything that we haven't heard before. It's just how they say it, it's a different angle, you know. Yeah. And just this whole idea that, you know, when we get to heaven, that the hallelujahs that they sing are endless, yeah. You know, and that's a pretty wide scoping idea.
Yeah, and I like the idea of, I think one of our jobs as worship leaders, songwriters, trying to bring people into the big picture, mm-hmm. and trying to get a bit more of the grand reality of what we're living in and what we're going to be living in.
Yeah.
And I think, you know, that's really the inspiration behind the song originally, was like, we need to live with this great big view,
yeah.
of God's endless hallelujah, his eternal kingdom, yeah. and the forever that we're going to have with him. And I think it can change our lives in the here and now when we do.
Absolutely. Thanks for sharing it.
Thanks, mate.